In this video, we will look at how to perform finger prick blood sampling. In the exercise physiology lab, we use finger prick blood sampling to get a small blood sample for a range of testing. This includes within lactate testing, in which we have a variety of portable handheld lactate analysers and one lab-based analyser. Finger prick blood sampling is also used for cholesterol and glucose testing. Before conducting finger prick blood sampling, it is important to ensure you are wearing appropriate PPE, including gloves, an apron and appropriate eye protection. Here on this tray you can see all the equipment needed. There's alcohol wipes, a safety lancet, tissues, additional gloves and appropriate clinical waste, including a sharp spin for sharp waste and a clinical waste bag for all additional clinical waste. The safety lancet we use to pierce the skin is a single-use safety lancet. It has three depths and these are not to scale. We commonly use the middle setting, which is indicated here with the notch, and would only really recommend the deeper setting on tougher skin such as callous skin. To change the depth setting, you rotate the middle section, however safety lancets are commonly already on the middle setting. In order to use a safety lancet, you need to twist and pull off the end purple sterile cap. Again, it's only the very end section you twist. Then, when you push the button, the lancet provides a quick, gentle puncture before it retracts permanently into its protective case. This is important as it means it cannot be accidentally reused. Next, we'll watch the process, in which you can see first we use an alcohol wipe to clean the area where we're going to take the blood sample. Please note that throughout we immediately place all clinical waste into the appropriate bin and never on the work surface. Once clean, using the safety lancet we've just looked at, twist off the end purple sterile cap. Then you're going to hold the lancet pushed gently into the fingertip and we'll look at location in a moment. Then firmly press the button and you will hear the safety lancet. Dispose of it immediately into the sharp spin. Next, wipe the first blob of blood away, which is important as it could be contaminated with alcohol from the wipe. Then gently squeeze and release the finger to milk and get a good blob of blood ready for sampling. Please notice that the sample site is at the fingertip. We don't use a fleshy pad, nor too close to the nail, as blood will trickle down the nail. We'll watch this again as a quick recap. First, ensure you're wearing appropriate PPE, then alcohol wipe the site. Next, using the safety lancet, pierce the site. Then wipe away a first blob of blood, then squeeze and release to milk the site. Here we will use the Lactate Plus portable analyzer. Later in the video, we will briefly look at our other portable devices. With the Lactate Plus, we have the associated test strip, and please notice that I have already taken one test strip out of the pot to avoid placing my finger in the pot and contaminating them. Insert the test strip into the analyzer until the device comes on. Once on, place the tip of the test strip to the blob of blood and notice how the blood is drawn up via capillary action. The machine will beep once the correct amount of blood is achieved. The Lactate Plus then takes 13 seconds to provide the result. Here we have a resting lactate result of 1 millimoles. Once again, dispose of the test strip in the sharps bin and the participant or athlete can wipe away the blood. As previously mentioned, we have a variety of portable lactate analysers in which we have multiples of each of the three of these analysers. We have the Lactate Plus, which is the yellow one, which we used in the video, the middle, which is the Lactate Pro 2, and on the right hand side we have the Lactate Scout analyser, each with their own specific test strips. Whilst each device provides lactate values, they differ and they take a slightly different amount of time to provide the results, require a slightly different amount of blood, and some provide different methods of analysing the lactate. However, from a practical consideration, the process to use them is exactly the same, in which each device has its own test strip, which you insert and draw the blood via capillary action, and then wait a short period of time for the result, Therefore, whichever portable analyzer you use, please follow the process shown in this video.